Hi there and welcome back to the Lally. In today's video, we will take a look at this DH30 mini spot welder kit. Come along. Let's take a look at what is inside the package. So first we have the charger, and then we have another case in there, and then a manual. If this has to do with Germany or was probably engineered in Germany, then it's going to be a good one. So in summary, we have the spot welder unit itself, a manual, some nickel strip for testing, the welding cables, a charger, and then a USB cable. You also have this case to keep all of these parts in. Let's look at build quality. Let's start from the cables. If I put this cable next to the type you usually buy in a shop or come in a phone box, you will notice that the thickness is practically almost the same, and this actually also feels very durable. The welding cables are 10 AWG as shown on the cable here, and 10 AWG simply means that the copper cable inside is 2.59 millimeters. AWG means American wire gauge. It's a standard for showing the thickness of cables. So this is 2.59 copper cable inside. And then the charger. This doesn't feel very durable, feels very plasticky and quite hollow or empty. Qualcomm quick charge 3.0, 5 volts at 3 amps. So this is a 15 watt charger. We will put it to the test and check it out at the end of this video when we've discharged this unit to some extent. And now to the main unit itself. This is made of metal, as you may have already noticed, and bolted on all the ends, front and back, with no screws on the sides or under. And I think this is a very good and compact build because it feels very solid and very premium. Let's now take a look inside and see what the gut is like. So upon opening, we realize that this circuit sits in the middle or center rail inside the case. So that makes the entire board kind of like stay hovering in this case. And then with these things being locked in place, the board cannot move forward or backwards, so it stays there. The extra feature they added was this part of the battery sits on this cushion-like thing over here that prevents the battery from directly touching the case. And in the front side as well, they have a similar foamy thing that is slightly raised above the battery to prevent that side also from touching the case, even though this is already sitting in the center of the case. And you can also tell from the circuit design that it's pretty clean. So far everything looks really nice and well arranged. We have this extra bars here to aid the high amount of current that will flow out for welding, so that energy is not lost in the form of heat or create extra losses where there shouldn't be. So this right here is the switching circuit for the USB output. This is the type C input, and I believe this might be the IC that is controlling the welding and everything else. This is the buzzer that makes the beep 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 sound when you are using the unit. This looks like there are two batteries in here, probably in parallel, to give the maximum amount of current that is stated on the device, which we'll be taking a look at. Or it's possibly just one huge cell, but I doubt it's possibly two. Everything has been nicely and compactly put together, so this is really cool. Let's put this back. Let's look at the specifications. According to the manufacturer, this has 30 gears. It's supposed to go from 1 to 30. That also corresponds to the pulses, I believe. It's touch sensitive. On the back here, we have a USB A out. You can plug something like this in and then use it to charge some other device. You charge it using the type C, which is a 5 volt 3 amp input. And then this is the power button. Same button you can use in changing modes. It has a 5000 milliamp hour battery, 4.2 volts at 650 amps. The thickness of the nickel that this can weld is 0.1 to 0.15 millimeter, but on the platform where I ordered this, I noticed they said from 0.1 to 0.2. I'll test the 0.2 as well and see if this still holds up to that or if it's just 0.15 as stated here. Let's power this up and test it. First, we have to remove these gummy things. We push this for 3 seconds. okay, it's on gear one. Count is zero because it's not being used to spot weld yet. You can see the battery in there is at 90%. It says ready, so let's go ahead and try it. We have the banana heads over here. I think this is gonna last quite a while. That's very strong. I think the connection is very strong because it's not very easy to push this inside. Let's try and spot weld something at one and see what happens. We'll try the 0.12 that came with it. According to the design, as soon as I put these two together on the strip, it should automatically spot weld after a few seconds. This is gear one. I bet we can easily remove this. To try gear two, all we need to do is just press this once and we can see this goes to gear two. Easily removed because it's just gear two. Now to gear three. As you can see, this is not my best work. So that also goes apart. Up to this point, we tried gear one, two, and gear three. So we are just going to go ahead and jump three steps ahead. Let's now try six. So we can see gear six is much more powerful. Okay, so at gear six, you can see separating them makes holes in them. So now we have gear nine. And the strip is quite warm. See gear 9, it bends a hole in the strip, which means that this is too much. I wonder what gear 20 or 30 would look like on this. And I can't seem to separate the strips anymore. It's stuck. Let's jump to gear 15 or gear 20. Let's try one of the higher gears and see how that goes. Okay, that was a lot. So at gear 15, you can see what happens here. So that just goes to show you how powerful this thing is. The nickel strip here is quite warm. You can see it bends a hole through the nickel strip here. So I've dropped this down to 5. So this is gear 5. You can see how clean and neat it is. At gear 5, if I try to rip it apart, okay, see, it's quite strong. Okay, see how much effort it takes for me to remove it, and when I do, a piece of it comes off. That is gear 5 on a 0.12 millimeter nickel strip. Now let's try the 0.15. So this is 0.15 at gear 5. It's quite neat. Okay, let's try to rip it apart and see if it works. It is a lot easier to rip these apart as compared to the 0.12 millimeter, but this also creates a little hole in the nickel. So let's now try gear 8 on the 0.15 millimeter. So gear 8 on the 0.15 millimeter. This is what we have. So this is quite easy to rip apart because these are much thicker, so it takes much more current to spot weld them. So gear 8 is not quite sufficient for these. So let's try gear 10 for the 0.15s. So at gear 10, this is what we have. Let's try and rip them apart and see. Okay, so at gear 10, it's much more difficult to rip apart. See? And if I try any harder, so at gear 10, they won't come apart. Yes, it does spot weld 0.15s around gear 10. So let's try 15, just to be sure. This is 15. And the nickel is quite warm. I think the back is getting stained because this thing here is burning and staining the back. This is stuck together very well. Even with struggles, it doesn't come off. So this is good. The 0.12s stick together very well at about gear 5. The 0.15 stick together very well at about gear 10. We can now try the 0.2. It turns out the 0.2 I thought I had was a 0.15. With the power and the results I'm seeing so far with the 0.15 and the 0.12, I think a 0.2 wouldn't be very difficult for this system to spot world, because it seems to have too much power for what I'm using it for. A 0.2 shouldn't be a problem. I'm going to try to spot world one of these 0.12 nickel strips onto this battery just to draw my final conclusions. So I'm going to set this to 5 because I realize that is the sweet spot for a good weld for the 0.12s. So you could just see the weld is quite neat, and even if I try to pull and it comes off, there are going to be some rips in the nickel strip, as you can see. The trick here is to experiment with a couple of nickel strips in the beginning to find where the sweet spot is for which nickel strip you have. So if you have a 0.12, I found out that the perfect spot weld should be around 5, 6, 7 thereabouts, and not more than 8. For the 0.15, it's 10, 11. I'm guessing maybe for the 0.2 millimeter, maybe 15 to 20. So here you can see it goes all the way up to 30. If you push the multifunction button at the back once, like this, it toggles between a couple of settings where you get to see other functions. Over here, it shows a history count of how many spot welds I've done. I've done 61 since the beginning of this video. The next one is the off timer. It's how much time this device stays on when it's idle. If you leave this without using it or spot welding for 3 minutes, it's going to go off, and you can just change it by increasing this number over here by just tapping this. And then another press, this is the wait timer, which is how much time it's waiting in between the detection of your leads on your nickel strip. So the higher time means it's going to wait a little bit longer for you to position your tips very well before the spot weld takes place. So that is that. To charge the unit, we are going to use the very charger that came with the package. The USB would insert a USB tester to see how much current really is going out and how much current this device says it is receiving. So we can see this device says it's charging at 4.68 volts. The input current is 1.8, so it's charging at about 8 watts. Let's go ahead and take a look at what this guy says it's giving out. This is at 5.06 at 1.2 amps. So I guess this goes a long way to say that it actually draws as much current as it will get to charge as fast as it can to the maximum charge. Now it's at 88% and it's stable. Now let's try things the other way and connect this here and see if it gives out the same amount of current. So this is showing output and this is on at 5.06 volts. I'm going to connect this here and then connect this end to an iPhone. Okay, so it begins charging, as you can see in the top, and let's see how much current this is giving out. Almost 1 amp at 5 volts. Let's try another device. I'll plug this USB in here and then I'll plug the other end into my JBL Charge 3, and you can see the JBL begins to charge and the amount of current drawn is about 500 milliamps. And the current is this low because the JBL was actually fully charged. I discharged it a little just to charge it in this video, so just for you guys. This is actually cool as a power bank because it has a 5000 milliamp hour battery in it. According to the manufacturer, applying so much force or pressure on the nickel strip doesn't guarantee a good spot weld. Rather, you just need to apply just enough force for the nickel strip to stay flat for the current to flow from one end to the other. Kindly give us a like if you find this video informative. If you are new here, kindly subscribe to stay in touch on how to design and build more cool stuff. See you next time.